You might wondering, you clicked on the trailer for the Virtual Joystick Pack, so why am I here talking to you? This is because I thought that it'd be easier for you to make a decision of whether this is the right asset for you if I showed you how the asset worked right in this video as opposed to an epic 2-minute trailer. So let's get right into it. Alright, so what we have here is a simple game. The bullet fires based on where the joystick is facing, right here. And of course, movement just allows you to move in four directions. So, how do you start using the Virtual Joystick? Once you download the Virtual Joystick asset, you will find a folder inside your assets folder. It's called Virtual Joystick. Just double click on it and go to the prefabs folder and then just drag any onto the canvas. And you should find that you will right away be able to start using the joystick. Except for the problem that the joystick doesn't control anything in your game. How do you make your joystick affect your game? It's really simple as well. We've designed the joystick so that it's really intuitive to use as long as you're using Unity's native input system. So normally when you want to read user input, you will use input galaxies, for example, right? Or input galaxies vertical. With the virtual joystick, all you gotta do is just replace that with virtual joystick and then horizontal or vertical instead of input here. To be able to use the virtual joystick though, you have to, in your code, wherever you're using the virtual joystick, add a namespace here using TerraSquare. And really that's all. Okay, the rest of it is just the same as the default Unity input system. And because the input system has a getAxis role, you also have a getAxis role for the virtual joystick. So there are a couple more ways that you can retrieve the axis values, but for that, those are a little more complex. We have a link to the guide, and I'm gonna need you to read that if you want to learn more about the different ways that you can use the virtual joystick. You also will notice that in our game, we have two joysticks, okay, excluding the one I just added. So how do you re-input from multiple joysticks then? Because this allows you to re-input only from one joystick, right? If you have multiple joysticks, for the second joystick, how do you re-input from it? You just add a comma behind your horizontal or vertical, and then this should be a 1, right? 1 will be for the second joystick, 2 will be for the third joystick in your screen, and 3 will be for the fourth joystick, and so on. So for me to re-input of the second joystick, it'll be getAxis horizontal 1, and getAxis vertical 1 like this. Just by adding a couple of lines of code where your input reading should be, you get the joystick working in your game. So you really set this up in 5 minutes. So I'm just going to go through some of the properties that you have in the joystick for you to control. Okay, so if you click on the joystick prefab that you use, okay, you will find a virtual joystick component. And in here, you will find a couple of properties that you can control. Okay, the first property over here is only on mobile. Okay, what this does is if you enable it, then it makes the joystick hide itself if you're not playing on mobile. Normally, I recommend not checking this. You only check this if you want a project to be able to export to both the phone and to PCs or other platforms. Second property here is drag color. Drag color basically controls what happens when you click on the joystick. So if I set the drag color to red here, for example, here you will see my joystick because I'm controlling the native joystick, right? A native joystick, when it's clicked on, it will turn red. Third is sensitivity. Sensitivity is just how responsive the joystick is to you. Okay, so for this property over here, if I reduce it to 1, for example, okay, what you will see is that now the joystick will become very sluggish. Okay? Whereas if I increase it, of course, it becomes very responsive. Okay, the third property is radius. Okay, what is radius? You will see radius controls this green circle on the joystick. Okay, this is just a UI marker to show you what the radius of the joystick is. Okay, if I increase the radius to 2, for example, you will find that I'm able to pull the joystick very far away from the center. The radius controls how far you are able to pull the joystick away from the center or the base. Now, the next thing I want to show you is the dead zone. The dead zone is just this red circle inside the green circle. And the dead zone controls when the joystick responds to you. Okay, so if the dead zone here is 0.3, it means that you have to move the joystick 30% away from the center for any input to register. Okay, this is what I'm going to use the movement joystick to show this to you. I'm just going to make a couple of changes over here. I'll set the dead zone here to 0.5. And what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to try and move the plane. One thing you'll notice is that the plane only starts moving when I move the joystick more than 50% away from the center. This is because the dead zone here is set to 0.5. The highest you can set a dead zone is to 1. If you set a dead zone to 1, it covers the entire radius. It causes the joystick to only work if you move the joystick to the edge. Okay, otherwise, it doesn't work. Alright, so normally you want a dead zone. 0.3 is default. Next property here is edge snap, which is quite an interesting property. Edge snap, what it does is that if you turn this on, okay, my dead zone here is 0.3, right? So if I pull away from the dead zone, you see that once it goes away, it snaps to the edge. That's what edge snap does. Next property is directions, and what directions does is that if you shift directions around, you will see lines appear in the joystick. Okay, so if I set direction to 2, for example, okay, you will see that now my joystick is only able to move in 2 directions. Okay, I can't move away from left or right. If I set directions to 4, my joystick is now only able to move in 4 directions, left, right, up, down. Okay, so this is a way for you to control how the joystick moves along certain axes. if you turn on directions, you will see that there is a new property that appears called angle offset as well. This allows you to play around with how you want the joystick to be configured in terms of its axis. So for example, if I have four directions at minus 45 degrees here, you will see my joystick is only able to move in diagonal direction. Okay, so between directions and angle offset, you have quite a lot of control over how the joystick can move around. Okay, which is pretty cool if you want to have certain movement restrictions in your game. Finally, we have snap to touch. For the split joystick, if I set snap to touch over here, I will also have to set boundaries. I'm just going to set this 0.5, 0.5. Setting the boundaries will cause you to see a yellow box that appears like that. So once I have the yellow box over here and I have snap to touch turned on, is that when I click on different parts of the screen, right, as long as it's within the boundaries, my joystick will always teleport there. See that? Okay, so you will see this feature appear in a bunch of mobile games. Finally, just two more fields over here, we have increased size and decreased size. Why is that? Because normally if you want to increase the size of your joystick, you have to change the width and the height. But if you do that, you will have to also change the size of the control stick as well, which is a little bit cumbersome. So we've made a set of buttons, two buttons, so that you can increase or decrease the size of your joystick in proportion and not have to worry about setting the right width and height. And that about wraps up the virtual joystick. So I hope you use our asset, give it a try.